Yeah. thank you so much. It's so good to be back here with you guys. We're here tonight to lift up and glorify the name of the Lord. That's what we do everywhere we go. No matter where you are in your life, folks, there's always hope. And our hope is found in Jesus.
By the blood.
Our thankful for the hope we have in Jesus. Oh, we have hope, folks, because no matter what we go through in this life, we're promised that God will always be on the throne. Amen. A sinner now saved, blood washed by the Lamb. My brother's a king. Oh, Well, thank you. I want to take just a minute and introduce these guys to you. You know, Gold City started in 1980, right up the road in Dahlonega, Georgia. Most of y'all already know that, but the most people don't know that this group was originated right up there in Dahlonega. That's where our name comes from. And back in 1984, my dad, Tim Riley, who sang bass here from 1980 up until 2014, relocated us back to our home in Gadsden, Alabama. We've been there ever since, but Georgia has a special place in our heart and always will. But these guys that are on the stage love the Lord, they love this music, and they love what they do. And I want to take just a moment to introduce them. Over here playing the piano, this young man is from Alexandria, Alabama. He is a fine, fine fella. Some people think he looks like an accountant. That's because he used to be one. But he is a fantastic piano player and even a better man. I love him, and I know you're glad to see him tonight. How about it for Mr. Terry Wooten? Over here singing the tenor for Gold City. He's a tenor singer. Tenor singers are a little different. You know, you can't be just an average person and do what he does. You got to be a little different. And they're temperamental tenor singers. You have to be careful how you talk to them. You kind of have to. But we love to get him stirred up. We love to push those buttons to get him all stirred up, because when he does, he sounds just like a cross between Mickey Mouse and Gomer Pyle.
Did you tell him to say it?
No, I said it all by myself. No, I know you're enjoying Chris tonight. He is from Greensboro, North Carolina. Would you make Mr. Chris Jenkins welcome? And over here singing the lead, Josh has been with Gold City since this past August, and the folks everywhere are falling in love with his lead voice. He sings just about anything. He can sing tenor, he can sing lead, he can try to sing baritone, but there's just not many people that can. But Josh comes from a rich heritage of gospel music. He comes from Sand Mountain, Alabama, and there's a lot of great gospel music that comes off of that mountain. And he is no exception. He's from Boaz, Alabama. Y'all glad to see Mr. Josh Feenstra. Singing the bass for Gold City. Been singing this music for about 37 years, just since he was just a little kid. And he does a fantastic job. He'll rattle you sternum if you ain't careful. He is our only Georgia boy. He's from Brunswick, Georgia. Y'all glad to see Jeff Chapman. My name's Daniel Riley, that's all of Gold City. Glad Gold City came back to Gainesville, Georgia.
Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word, just to rest just to know, thus saith the Lord, Jesus, Jesus, how I trust.
say tonight that I'm packed and ready to go, that I have my reservation sure, that I know beyond a shadow of a doubt where I'll go when I leave this walk of life. That's our hope and our prayer, that each and every person in this room can have that same assurance tonight.
Amen.
I'm thankful for the place that awaits us, but I'm more thankful that God loved me enough that He made a way through His Son Jesus Christ. That Christ bled and died on Calvary's cross willingly. Why? So that you and I could have life eternal. Oh, what grace it must have took to keep Him there on that cross. And when I think about that in my mind, folks, I can't comprehend why somebody would love me, a sinner, so much that they would be willing to give their life on a rugged cross, one of the most cruel deaths and ways that you could die. Yet Christ did it willingly for you and me. Kirk Talley sent Gold City a song way back in the early 1980s, and I don't believe I've ever quite heard it put this way, but I love what the songwriter said. He said, "I don't believe there's any other word that you can describe God's grace except amazing." You listen to this. I hope it blesses your heart.
Yeah.
tempter. He says, oh, I'm a turnaround. You can't get any farther, because you're just a losing clown. Oh, but I'm not giving up. No, I'm not turning around. By the grace of God, I'll wear a shining crown. Someday, yes, I'll keep holding on to His best heart. And oh, no, I'm not giving up. No, I'll keep going on. Now, would you mind to tell me there's been something? What is it, that old devil? He just wanna let God's children be.
Sitting here just playing church. I did it as a kid. I didn't get saved until I was 19 years old. Started traveling and singing when I was 17 years old. Went out there just doing the same thing I'm doing here for about 3 years until I came to know Jesus on a Sunday evening. Sitting back here in the corner, thought I had it all together. That night that Jesus made me realize that I was as lost as any murderer, any bank robber, anybody out there. So no matter who you are or what, where you came from, what your background is, you gotta know Jesus. You can't enter the kingdom of heaven upon your works and what you do. You gotta know Jesus and know Him as your personal Lord and Savior. It takes a belief. But I'm thankful for a God that has taken me so far in this life and showed me some amazing things. See, my very steps are ordered by God, the Bible says. There's nothing that's going to happen that'll freak God out. Has it ever occurred to you that nothing occurs to God? I serve a living God that's been here before the beginning of time and will be here long after. There's an old song that Tim Riley made famous for years. And it says it best than anything in this world, that God is all under control. Everything's under control. The Bible speaks of famines and trials in the last days, how they'll sweep through our land. But we have His assurance that through all these trials we'll be led by His mighty hand. Manna from God will come down from above to restore and to nourish us.
But I know you don't really like to sing it. But you know what?
I didn't say I don't like.
Well, no. Okay, I don't like for you to sing it. Okay. Mike Lefevre is here tonight. Right back there. See him? Mike, I'm putting you on the spot. Come on. Come on up here and sing this. Come on up and sing this with us. Y'all clap for Mike. He's waiting for you. But it's kind of been a dream of mine to always get to sing this song with Mike Lefevre. Chris and I and Jeff and Danny and Terry, we all grew up huge fans of Gold City. And it's really interesting how we all got here and how we're here now. But we're so excited to be able to carry on the legacy that these guys did. I hate to put you on the spot, but you know it well. Let's go, Terry. Come on.
Things I know but I cannot show, one day will overflow.
I've known Mike Lefevre since I was just a little boy. He never gets old. But he actually is pretty old. You came with Gold City at the end of 1984, and I was 12 years old when you joined this group. And you were about, what, 14?
Well, I don't know, but you were the same size then you are now.
You're right. I just want to say, and I've said this to Mike, I've said it in front of people, he is one of my favorite people. Yep. He's one of the first people to call when something is wrong to encourage you. And I love him, and I mean that with all of my heart. I love you, and I love Miss Kathy, and I love Jordan, I love your whole family.
Thank you, and I love y'all too. Listen, I got to tell y'all, I sat back there and I've been listening, and I felt the anointing. When I came in, we've been at my church, we've been in a time of prayer and fasting. And I told Kathy, I felt this, it's just an overwhelming, just an oppression feeling. And I told her just a few minutes ago after I heard y'all sing, I felt that lift. And man, y'all are awesome. Didn't you enjoy Gold City?
Have you enjoyed Gold City so far tonight? Our prayer that you are ready, that if the Lord were to come right now, you'd be ready and you'd fly away in your robe of white straight into heaven in the presence of our Lord. We've enjoyed being here for you tonight. It's our prayer every time that we step out onto a stage that God would take the ordinary guys that you see up here and use us in some way to be an encouragement to His people and to point people to the cross. We never go into a church assuming that everybody's ready. You can go to church and you can still go to hell. It's just the reality. We all face an eternity, either in heaven or in hell. And there is only one way to spend your eternity in heaven. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. So tonight, if the Holy Spirit is working in your heart, and you need to talk to somebody, you need somebody to pray with, there's nothing that would thrill us any more than to be able to do that. So don't leave here tonight and not be ready. There's assurance in knowing that if I fall over dead on this stage before we get finished, I can promise you this. The Bible says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And folks, I'm looking forward to the day. I'm not ready to get up the load right this minute, but we can't fathom in our feeble little minds what we have ahead of us. But I know it's going to be wonderful. If all He did was bless me while I'm on this earth, it's worth it. God has been so good to me. Before you leave here tonight, come see us. Like I said, if you need to pray with somebody or you need to talk to somebody, we'd love to do that. But folks, let's be ready. I believe at any moment we could hear the midnight cry. God bless y'all. We love you. Thank you for having Gold City tonight.
Of a mighty rushing wind,
to see him tonight, just wave.
Prophecies fulfilled. Oh, and the signs of the time, they're appearing everywhere. I can almost hear my father as he says, "Son, go.
Thank you. I know that the pastor is dealing with a stomach virus, you said. The minister of music is, it's just all upside down tonight, but hadn't they done a wonderful job?
I'm on now. That is good. How many of you have enjoyed Gold City? I'm going to tell you something. They're coming back. The preacher's wife has spoken. So, you know, I got the mic tonight. Anyway, it is, thank you for all for coming. I tell you something I love about this group. Many times we invite groups to come and sing, and they talk. We invite you to sing. Now, if the Lord gets in it, you can talk all you want to. But we love it. And these guys, they didn't talk a whole lot. They just put it out there, didn't they? And they got tremendous voices. So thank you for that. If you don't have a home church, we would love to have you here. We sing the old stuff. We sing some of the new stuff. We have a full band most of the time. So anyway, if you don't have a home church, we would love to have you come. So in way of dismissal, let's sing that old song, "Oh How I Love Jesus." We'll do it without any music. Singing, "Oh How I Love Jesus." Oh. Because lift your hands and sing. Oh, yes, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. You may be dismissed. Have a good and safe night.